प्रेजेंट सर।
राइट। शफिया प्रेजेंट
प्रेजेंट
सर। ओके। श्रीधर
सर।
राइट। सृष्टि
प्रेजेंट
ओके। सिद्धार्थ वर्णेकर। सिद्धार्थ पाटिल। सुप्रिया
प्रेजेंट सर।
ओके। वंदना वंदना। वसंत। वेदता। योगेश। महेश। बालेश। तैक मोहम्मद। प्रवीण राठौड़। अभिषेक। ऐश्वर्या।
प्रेजेंट
बनोड़कर तनय मोहनदास। बनोड़कर तनय मोहनदास। बावराव। शोधन।
प्रेजेंट सर।
शोधन राइट।
प्रेजेंट सर।
ओके। द्यावनवर अनिल कुमार शेखप्पा।
प्रेजेंट सर। प्रेजेंट
राइट। नंद कुमार। प्रमोद। प्रमोद। रोहिणी। रोहित अलवाणी। शशिधर गौडर। शशिधर। श्रीधर।
प्रेजेंट सर।
ओके। स्नेहल। स्नेहल वैष्णवी।
प्रेजेंट
राइट। साईश।
प्रेजेंट
ओके। कार्तिक। स्मिता। स्मिता। किरण। ओके। एनीबडी एल्स ज्वाइंट? अक्षता बेलदी। राइट। अक्षता बेलदी ज्वाइंट। एनीबडी एल्स? What we are discussing in the last class? What we are discussing in the last class?
Programs.
Programs, right? Let us take up a simple program which is interfacing between LCD to microcontroller. The statement goes like this: the data pins of an LCD are connected to P1. The information is latched into the LCD whenever its enable pin goes from high to low. Write an 8051C program to send "the earth is but one country" to this LCD. What is the statement? The data pins of an LCD are connected to P1. That means the port P1 of microcontroller is connected to liquid crystal display. LCD is liquid crystal display. It's a display screen. The information is latched into the LCD. Whatever information we are sending from the port P1 of the microcontroller, that will be sent to the LCD and it will be stored there. This is called as latching. This is called latching, latch into the LCD whenever its enable pin goes from high to low. Whenever the LCD pin goes from enable pin goes from high to low, that time the data that we are sending from the port P1 of the microcontroller, that will be stored onto the LCD. That is, we have to write an 8051C program to send "the earth is but one country" to this LCD. That is, the message is "the earth is but one country". This message we have to send from the microcontroller, that is from port P1, and it has to be stored onto the LCD screen. Okay, so for this we have to write a program. Statement is clear, right? Okay. Now, if we want to write a program here, then the ports we have to initialize. We have to initialize the ports, and we have to declare the ports, right? So for declaration of the ports, let us start with the header file, hash include reg51.h, hash include reg51.h, reg51.h. Then we have to define the port P1, we have to define it. Okay, define. What is the meaning of define? Instead of using port P1 in the program, we can make use of the alternative name that we are giving for the port P1. LCD data P1. Okay, this is the LCD data declaration for the LCD data declaration. Okay, then we have to define the pin which we are making use of, the enable pin. For the enable pin must be defined, like how we define the LCD data. Similarly, we have to define the enable pin. Yes bit enable, this is equal to P2.0. Okay. I'm making use of P2.0. That is, how is the interfacing here? We are interfacing the microcontroller to the LCD. On one side, there is microcontroller that we are connecting it to the LCD screen, right? For the data pins, we are making use of port P1 to send the data from the microcontroller to the LCD, and to enable the storing of whatever data we are sending from the microcontroller to the LCD, we are making use of the enable pin. When we send high to low pulse on this enable pin of the LCD, whatever data is received by the LCD, that will be stored onto it, that will be latched onto the LCD screen, and it will be displaying those characters onto its screen. Clear? S bit enable is equal to P2.0. Then come to the main function, void main. And in the main function, we have to define the message. What is the message they have given? The earth is but one country. Unsigned. Unsigned character message. I'll make use of the variable message. You can write MEST or MESSAGE, anything will do. Message within the closed empty brackets. What is the message? Put it into double quotes, because it is a set of characters. Single character we can put it in a single quote, but if it is set of characters, we have to put it into double quotes. The message is the earth is but one country. Okay, earth is but one country. This is the message. Okay, now we have to declare the variable for sending the characters. I'm making use of loop index. Unsigned character z. Next, start with the for loop. For loop index is z, therefore for z is equal to 0, right? Z less than, how many characters are there? Just count here. T is one character, H is second character, E is third character, space is also one character. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. Almost 28 characters. Okay. That is Z less than 28, 27 characters, Z less than 28, Z less than 28, Z plus plus. Z plus plus. Then send the set of characters, send the message. Okay. So for storing the message onto the LCD, we are making use of LCD data, this one, port P1. Right? That is LCD data is equal to message of Z. Here we can see here unsigned character Z. Z is equal to 0. When Z is equal to 0, first character will be accessed. Message of 0 means T, the letter T, alphabet. Next, when Z is 1, the next character H, next Z will be incremented, next character E. Like this, it will go on incrementing and it will go on accessing the characters. Where these characters are sent, they are sent from port P1. We are sending them from port P1 of the microcontroller. The port P1 we have defined it as LCD data. LCD data is the port P1. Okay. So from port P1 of the microcontroller, we are sending the set of characters from microcontroller to the LCD screen. Now, there may be one question here. That is whether the characters are sent like this. Whether T sent, H, L, E, these letters are they sent or something else is sent? Actually, these characters, alphabets are not sent. The ASCII characters of these alphabets are sent. The ASCII characters of these alphabets are sent, not the characters, right? Because the microcontroller can only understand the language of zeros and ones. Therefore, the ASCII characters in terms of hex that is sent of each of these alphabets. There is some ASCII character for T, ASCII character for H, ASCII character for R, ASCII character for S. So each one of these are having its own ASCII characters. Those ASCII characters are sent from the microcontroller to the LCD screen. Now, once we send the characters, next we have to make the enable pin high to low. They are mentioned in the program statement that the enable pin should be used to latch the data onto the LCD screen. Enable pin of the LCD, if we send a high to low pulse on the enable pin, then the data will be latched onto the LCD screen. Got the point here? It is make the enable pin enable equal to 1 first time, then next enable equal to 0. Enable equal to 0. Once we are making enable 1 to 0, right? That means whatever data we have sent from the port P1 of the microcontroller, that will be stored onto the LCD screen and the characters will be displayed. What are these characters? These characters, THEARTHIS, these characters will be displayed on the LCD screen. Therefore, end the for loop. This should be done for indefinite number of times and then end the main loop. This is how the characters are sent from the port P1 of the microcontroller to the LCD screen. Is this program understood yet? This program is understood. Any doubts in this program? Any questions here on this program? Is this program clear here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let us move on to the next program. Write a program to toggle all bits of P0, P1 and P2 with the 250 millisecond delay. We have to write a program to toggle the bits of P0, P1 and P2 with 250 millisecond delay. But we have done this previously. Toggling of bits program we have already written previously, but this is slightly different from the previous one. Here they are asking to use the SFR keyword. Use the SFR keyword to declare port addresses. To declare the ports, we have to make use of SFR keyword, special function register. Because these P0, P1 and P2, they are special function registers. We have to declare these P0, P1 and P2 as SFRs, and then we can use them in our program. And they have also mentioned to introduce a delay of 250 milliseconds. Delay should be 250 milliseconds, right? Start with the header file. Hash include reg51.h. Now, sorry, here we have to make use of SFR keyword, not the hash reg51, because they have clearly mentioned to make use of the SFR keyword. SFR P0 is equal to 0x80 is the memory location where port P0 is stored. Port P0 is stored in the memory location 80H memory location. That means whatever bits you are storing in port P0, they will be stored in 80H memory location, right? So we know that what is the special function register RAM space? RAM space of special function registers, from what to what memory location it is? In 8051?
-127 to 127.
No. Special function register RAM space. Space in the RAM memory for the special function registers. 80H to FFH. Try to recollect what we discussed in module 1. 80H to FFH. These are the memory locations where the special function registers, all the special function registers of 8051 microcontroller are stored in between the memory locations 80H to FFH, right? That is, here port P0, the first one, it is stored in the 80H memory location, first memory location of the, that is where the SFRs are started storing from. SFR P0 is equal to 0x80. Then similarly define port P1, SFR P1 is equal to, next is 0x90. Then for port P2, similarly define port P2, SFR P2 is equal to 0xA0. Once we have defined the ports, then they have also asked to use the delay function, or to introduce a delay, use the delay function, void, define it, ms delay of unsigned int, void ms delay of unsigned int. Anything else to be declared? We have declared the ports to toggle them, and we have defined the delay function. Okay. Anything else we have to define? Loop indices will be declaring in the loop itself. Next, start with the main function, void main. Next, in the main function, it has to be repeated for indefinite number of times. Use the while loop, while of one. We have to toggle with the 250 millisecond delay. That is, first, what is the data that we have to store for toggling? What data we need to store for toggling?
One.
Data for toggling 55 and AA. Correct? We have to store 55 first, we have to toggle it to AA. Or we can store AA first and we can toggle it to 55, 55H. Like this. See, 55 is, I'm writing in the form of a comment, 0101 0101 55, and toggle this. Once you toggle this, what you will get? 1010 1010. This is 55. 55, if it is getting toggled, then we'll be getting AAH. Or if we toggle AAH, we'll get 55. Either way, okay. Here, let's store the value 55 in all the three ports. 0 is equal to, how to store them? 0x55. Then port P1 is equal to 0x55. P2 is equal to 0x55. P0, P1, and P2. Next, we have to toggle. In between toggle and toggling, we have to introduce the delay. Call the delay function. Okay. So MS delay of 250 milliseconds. MS delay of 250. Because they have mentioned in the program to use the delay of 250. MS delay of 250. Okay. Then next. Now we have to toggle. Call the delay function. It will introduce the delay of 250 milliseconds. Then it will come to the main program. Then toggle the bit ports. P0 is equal to 0xAA. Then P1 is equal to 0xAA. P2 is equal to 0xAA. We have toggled them. After toggling, again there should be a delay. Call the delay function. MS delay of 250. This is, we have toggled. It has served our purpose. Our logic is written. Once the logic is written, then end the while loop first, then end the main program. Okay. Next is, we have to write the delay function. We have not yet written the delay function. We know how to write the delay function. Void MS delay of unsigned int i time, then consider the for loops. Two for loops we have to use. For use some loop index, define them. I will use I is equal to 0, i less than i time, i plus plus. Then next, for j is equal to 0, what is the value? J less than how much? Yes, anybody? J less
one
than?
1275.
1275, exactly. 1275, j plus plus. Then end the two for loops. We have not yet defined the loop indices. Define the loop indices. It is unsigned integer i comma j. This is the program for toggling the data of port P0, P1 and P2 continuously with a 250 millisecond delay, but by considering the special function registers. If we are not considering the special function registers, then we would have used hash include reg51.h. When we are using hash include REG51.h, it means all the declarations of the special function registers, all the registers is already by default included in the header file REG51.h. Got the point? Now, if we are not making use of hash include REG51.h, then we have to define them. Then we have can use the different variables or the registers, whatever we have defined into our program, right? Is this program clear, students? Is this program clear here? Understood this program? Any doubts here in this program? Mole?
No, sir.
Any questions?
No.
Okay. Understood, Mole?
Understood, sir.
Okay, right. Akshata, is it understood? Akshata? Bhakti?
Yes, sir.
Clear with the programs?
Yes, sir.
Right. Pooja? Nandish?
Yes, sir. Understood, sir.
Fine. Priyanka? Supriya?
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Yes, sir. Supriya? Understood. Yes, sir.
Okay. Shodhan?
Yes, sir. Understood, sir.
Right. Devan or Anil Kumar Shekappa? Sridhar Badige?
No doubt, sir. Understood, sir.
No doubts? Fine. Good. Let us take up the next program. Write 8051C program to turn bit P1.5 on and off 50,000 times. Read the statement. Write 8051C program to turn bit P1.5 on and off 50,000 times. Can anybody tell me the meaning of this statement? What does it mean?
Toggling.
Exactly. We have to turn the bit on and off. That means first we have to make pin P1.5 high. Then next time we have to make P1.5 low. Okay. Turn bit P1.5 on and off. How many times this way has to be repeated? It has to be repeated for 50,000 times. It has to be repeated for 50,000 times. If it has to be repeated for 50,000 times, then which data type we are supposed to use? For repeating 50,000 times, which one we can use?
Integer.
Correct. Yes. Int we have to use. Unsigned integer that will be supporting the particular 50,000 data that is being given in the program statement. Let us write a program for this. Let us define the bit what they have mentioned to toggle. Let us define that bit. Yes bit. Again, we are not making use of the header file. If we are not making use of the header file, we have to define. Here it says, as it is a single bit, they have mentioned specifically to make use of P1.5. Therefore, we have to define it. We can make use of the header file and define it, or header file may be skipped off and then only the declaration or the definition of that port pin can be done. That also can be done. Yes bit, my bit is equal to 0x95. In previous programs, what we had done, we had written yes bit, my bit is equal to P1.5. That means S bit, my bit, P1.5. That means wherever there is P1.5 to be written in the program, that will be replaced by my bit. That means wherever we can make use of P1.5, instead of P1.5, we can make use of only my bit, so that the program becomes simple. Here what we are doing, S bit, my bit is equal to 0x95. This 95 is nothing but it's the memory location of the pin P1.5. It is the memory location of the pin P1.5, port 1, 5th bit, that is 6th bit from D0. Okay, D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, 6th bit. That bit is nothing but P1.5. This is another way of declaring the pins. If you are able to remember the memory location of the pins and the SFRs, then directly you can make use of the memory locations of the ports and of that of the port pins. Okay. If you are not able to remember, then you can make use of S bit, my bit is equal to P1.5. That can also be done. Okay. Then write the main function. void main, then define the variable, that is for the loop index. They have asked to repeat for 50,000 times. Unsigned int, any variable you can use, z or y or x, any variable. Unsigned int z. For loop, we have to repeat it for 50,000 times. So make use of for loop. For z is equal to 0, z less than 50,000, z less than 50,000, z plus plus. For z is equal to 0, z less than 50,000, z plus plus. This is the for loop. Now, what we are supposed to do here, we have to turn it on and off for these many number of times. So use the looping here, for loop, that is my bit is equal to 1 and my bit is equal to 0. Simple. My bit is equal to 0. So toggled. That means this toggling is repeated for 50,000 times as per the loop index. If we want, then we can introduce a delay here. If you are writing the delay function, then we have to define the delay function also. If you are writing here MS delay of 250 milliseconds, if you are calling the delay function, then we have to define it. That is void MS delay of unsigned int I time. For I is equal to 0, I less than I time, I plus plus. For I is equal to 0, I less than 1275, I plus plus. For j is equal to 0, j less than 1275, j plus plus. We have to define it. Okay. If we are not making use of the delay function, then just write if my bit is equal to 1, my bit is equal to 0. Whatever is the internal delay of that microcontroller, it will take that and accordingly it will toggle from 1 to 0 and 0 to 1. Okay. Then end the for loop, main function. We have ended the for loop here, then end the main function. So this is the program for toggling or turning on and off. Both mean one and the same. Either they may mention in the examination toggle P1.5 for 50,000 times, or they may mention turn bit on and off for 50,000 times. They can use in any one of the ways. Both mean one and the same. Any doubts here in this program, students? Any doubts in this program?
No, sir.
Right. Let's move on to the next one. Write 8051C program. 1 minute. Write 8051C program to get status of bit P1.0, save it and send it to P2.7 continuously. Write 8051C program to get status of bit P1.0, save the data and then send it to P2.7. That means P1.0 will become the input pin, we are getting this data from port P1.0 intersection to some of the variable, single bit variable, special bit, and then from that bit we have to send it to P2.7. P1.7.0 will be input pin and P2.7 will be output pin according to the program statement. Yes or no? Let us write the program for this. Start with the header file. Hash include reg51.h. Then we have to define P1.0 and P2.7, what they have mentioned in the statement. S bit, special bit, in bit, special bit, in bit is equal to, because we are making use of that as the input bit, therefore I will name it as in bit P1.0. Then S bit, output bit, output pin, S bit output is equal to, which is the output pin they have mentioned in the statement, P2.7. We are defining them as input and output. Okay. Then for using a variable or a bit, I'm declaring it as some bit, memory bit, some bit in the memory location, bit memory bit. This is, we are declaring it as a bit, single bit. This is a variable and this is the way in which we have to define the single bit. If it is a single bit, then we have to define it as bit. Okay. If it is more than one bit, then it is a SFR or S bit. If it is single bit, S bit. If it is more than one bit, it is SFR, comes under SFR. Okay. So bit, sir, memory bit. Yes, please.
Sir, the case means the C language is case sensitive, sir.
Yes.
So these starting letters are small or caps, sir?
Correct, you are right. See, it is case sensitive. This is also case sensitive. 8051 C language is case sensitive. That is why you have to be little bit careful when you are writing in the when you are executing the program. That time you have to be careful, because what happens, instead of a capital letter, if you use small letters, instead of small letters, if you use capital letters, then it will show error. Then you have to go to that particular line. You have to make that to particular caps or lower caps or upper case or lower case, and then run it so that you'll get the correct output. Okay. So it is case sensitive. Here S bit is capital. This S is capital here. This is smaller one. This is smaller one. Okay. It has to be like this. Right. This is a particular way. While writing, no problem. Okay. Small here and there, no problem. But when executing, you have to be careful, because it is case sensitive. When executing, definitely uppercase and lower case does matter. Uppercase and lowercase does matter. Therefore, while executing, we have to take care. Utmost care should be taken when executing the programs. Clear here?
Yes,
got
sir.
The point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Bit memory bit. Then come to the main function. Void main. Then we have to read the P1.0, and that has to be done, have they mentioned number of times, send it to be continuously. When it is continuously, we have to make use of for loop or the while loop. So while of one, if they are not mentioning how many number of times, it is simple to make use of while statement. If they are mentioning, that is 50,000 times or 10,000 times, then we have to make use of the for loop. If that figure is not mentioned, number of times toggling or number of times turning on and off, if it is not mentioned, then we can simply make use of while statement, a simple one. While of one, then we have to read this P1.0 into mem bit, into the memory bit. So what I will do, I'll assign memory bit is equal to inbuilt. That means whatever data we are reading from the port P1.0, that means whatever we are reading from this variable inbuilt, that will be stored in this bit, memory bit. It's a variable. Then from here, what they are asking to do, read the status of bit P1.0, save it, that means store it, and then send it to P2.7. You have to now send it to P2.7, which is our P2.7 here. P2.7 is out bit here, this one. Now whatever data we have stored in this variable, single bit variable, mem bit, that we have to send it to P2.7. Output is equal to mem bit. Output is equal to mem bit. We have sent the data that we have read on port P1.0 to P2.7. Then end the while loop, then end the main loop, then end the main loop. Two opening brackets, two closing brackets, two opening flower brackets, two closing flower brackets. So this is the indentation. This we are calling it as indentation. Indentation means how many opening brackets should be there, the same number of closing brackets should also be there. Is this program clear here, students? Understood this program? Any difficulty here? Any difficulty in this program? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Any questions here? Any questions? Saish, any questions? Saish?
No, sir.
Understood, no, sir. Saish?
Yes,
clear
sir.
With the programs? Okay, right. Vaishnavi, any doubts? Vaishnavi? Taik Mohammad, any doubts? Taik Mohammad? Bhakti, any doubts? Bharti?
No, sir.
Good. Bharti? Any doubts, Bharti? Jyoti? Nandish?
No doubt, sir.
Okay. Priyanka? Shabaz?
Yes, sir.
Any question, Shabaz?
No, sir.
Okay. Shafia?
Sir, understood,
Shafia?
Sir. Understood? Sir, understood.
Okay, good. Sridhar? Sridhar?
Yeah, understood, sir.
Okay. Srushti? Is it clear, Srushti? Aishwarya?
Yes, sir.
Understood, Aishwarya?
Yes, sir.
Okay. In the next class, I'll be taking up the logical operators. That next part is logical operators in 8051 C language, where I will be discussing about the various logical operators, AND operator, OR operator, XOR, right? Those logical operators we will discuss, inverter operator, that is NOT operation. And then we will discuss few programs on the logical operators. That we will take up in the next class. Okay. Thank you.